前苏联国家有一些过去是特别反对苏联的，反对俄罗斯的，像波罗的海三小国或者是波兰等国家，但是有一些国家呢仍然相当的亲俄。最近有一个国家值得大家注意，因为它正是全球认为它违反人权问题，它对于反对派的镇压过度，因此对它实施制裁的白俄罗斯。白俄罗斯一不做二不休，干脆和俄罗斯进行了接近统一形态的第一个28项计划，包括产业政策统一、采购国家订单统一、劳动立法统一、社会保险统一、养老金统一，一大堆统一方案。大家说，那你白俄罗斯是准备并入俄罗斯的土地吗？他们说不一定。2023年12月1号的时候，他们还会签署天然气的统一市场协定，所以会不会白俄罗斯慢慢的就跟俄罗斯变成一个接近是它的一部分的政治一体化？首先呢，他们说这需要经济基础。而当白俄罗斯跟俄罗斯如此紧密地站在一起，等于是俄罗斯势力的一个扩大，对欧洲来讲，俄罗斯当然是一个最可怕的威胁。
The Belarusian army said, if you saw you again, we would kill you. They took everything from us.
It's a bad war, and we were the weapons.
We're on the front lines of what the European Union says is a hybrid war on Europe, accusing Belarusian dictator Alexander Lukashenko of using migrants as weapons, purposefully luring them into Belarus from countries like Iraq and Syria by promising them easy access to Europe, then sending them over Belarus's border.EU officials believe it's his way of getting revenge after European countries supported the pro-democracy movement in Belarus and imposed sanctions on his regime.
The Polish border is sealed. Belarusian authorities told you lies. Go back to Minsk.
A Polish-based refugee support network has raised the alarm about around 30 refugees who are trapped between the borders of Poland and Belarus with nowhere to go. Security forces on both sides refusing to let them cross into their country.
Poland's parliament has approved construction of a border wall with Belarus to try and stop the flow of migrants. The wall will reportedly cost about $400 million and will include a monitoring and detection system.
渴望寻求庇护的中东和非洲移民成白俄和欧盟对峙下的牺牲者。白俄罗斯被指控操弄移民报复欧盟。欧盟近年来早就担心移民问题成为土耳其、白俄罗斯和俄罗斯这些国家的攻击武器，更何况白俄罗斯总统卢卡申科投向俄国总统普丁的怀抱，双俄携手还计划在白俄和乌克兰边境部署俄产防空飞弹系统，东斯拉夫三国关系更加牵动欧洲和北约神经。
Belarusian leader Alexander Lukashenko and Russian President Vladimir Putin have decided to deepen economic ties between their two nations. During their recent meeting, they agreed on forming common energy and financial markets.
This drill is held every 4 years, but it's now taking place amid rising tensions.Experts say Russia has long been pushing for a deeper military foothold in Belarus, which it sees as a security buffer between Europe and NATO.
By invading Ukraine, Putin was able to destabilize and stop it from developing a stronger relationship with Western Europe.
白俄从主持乌俄和谈变成助阵俄国对抗乌克兰，同时基辅批评明斯克打压异己的声量也逐渐调高，乌克兰和白俄关系恶化。CNN 日前的独家报道还揭发白俄破坏乌克兰诱捕俄罗斯佣兵的计划。
So our former Ukrainian military intelligence sources told us they set about creating a fake private military company with its own Russian language website. On it, they advertised jobs like one lucrative contract at $5,000 a month to protect oil facilities in Venezuela. That was the bait, and we're told hundreds of Russian mercenariesactually took it.
We started to call them and say, hey man, okay, tell me something about yourself. Maybe you are not really a fighter. Maybe you are a plumber or something like that. And then they started to reveal things about themselves, sending us documents, military IDs, and proof of where they'd fought. And we are like, bingo, we can use that.
They're sending you evidence of who they are.
Yes, they sent it to us.
There were two who were present.When the missile that downed MH17 was launched, four others were members of a group responsible for shooting down our military aircraft and killing at least 70 of our best men. So identifying and punishing these people was of high interest to us.
The feeling I got was very bad because it meant all our hard work had gone down the drain. We'd carefully prepared for more than a year in the hope that justice would prevail and that these bandits would be in prison and punished. Unfortunately, this didn't happen.
According to our sources, the Ukrainian-led operation got some U.S. cash, technical assistance, and advice from the CIA on drawing Russian mercenaries in. A senior U.S. official told CNN those allegations are false.
乌克兰作为美国在东欧制衡俄罗斯不可或缺的同盟，但在美国权衡和欧洲盟友与俄罗斯关系下，乌克兰时不时被冷落，甚至被牺牲。现又眼看美国弃守进驻了20年的阿富汗，引发对美国的承诺担忧和信赖危机。乌克兰总统泽伦斯基8月31号到9月2号出访美国和拜登会面，就是要确认美国心中是否还有乌克兰。
As we celebrate 30 years of Ukrainian independence, the partnership between our nations goes stronger, and it's going to even become stronger than it has been. And the United States remains firmly committed to Ukraine's sovereignty and territorial integrity, and the face of Russian aggression.
白宫表示，拜泽会就是要展现美国维护乌克兰主权和领土完整的承诺。泽伦斯基是拜登上台以来第二位造访白宫的欧洲国家领导人。幕僚说，这足以清楚传达乌克兰是拜登政府的外交优先事务。拜登也表达访乌愿望。美国总统上次访乌是2008年布希执政时。
Могла бы сказать, что использование Вашингтоном Киева в качестве такого антироссийского орудия, мы это неоднократно говорили, может привести к весьма предсказуемым и печальным последствиям.
As you know, sir, President Biden has approved a new $60 million security assistance package, including Javelin anti-armor systems and more to enable Ukraine to better defend itself against Russian aggression.
乌克兰希望获得美国军务和经济援助，就在于俄国从未放弃收编乌克兰。乌东战事打了7年不见终结，乌克兰虽担忧步上阿富汗后尘，但毕竟华府没派兵帮基辅打仗，对乌克兰军队的金援也远低于阿富汗。乌克兰也自认是足以让美国依赖的抗俄伙伴。